starring Chris Hemsworth and Daniel Brühl, and directed by Ron Howard, is a 2013 film about the real-life relationship and rivalry between Formula One drivers James Hunt and Niki Lauda in the 1970s, when sex was safe and racing was dangerous. Daniel Brühl plays Niki Lauda, a brilliant driver with an intimate knowledge of his car's engineering. In Formula 3, he first meets James Hunt, played by Chris Hemsworth, an adrenaline-fueled playboy with an intimate knowledge of every woman he could get. The two formed a friendship and a rivalry. Rush tells the story mainly as a rivalry as the drivers rise up to the Formula One grid, where eventually they compete for the world championship, with Hunt driving for McLaren and Lauda driving for Ferrari. In 1975, Lauda won 5 Grand Prix victories and ultimately won the world championship. In 1976, Hunt was still chasing Lauda for the championship, but a terrible tragedy would befall Lauda at a circuit he had tried in vain to get his fellow drivers to boycott, the notorious Nürburgring. This was back when Formula One still raced on the legendary Nordschleife, which Jackie Stewart later dubbed Green Hell. Badly burned in his car crash at the German Grand Prix, Lauda, who had a healthy lead for the championship, was disfigured and hospitalized with 6 races left in the Formula One season. Just 6 weeks after his accident, Lauda was beginning to get back behind the wheel, and only missing 2 Grand Prix, he would return in the Italian Grand Prix to carry on his fight for the championship. Rush tells the story of not only the rivalry between Hunt and Lauda, but Lauda's resolve to carry on, and the sacrifice he makes when faced with having to hold onto the championship on another wet and dangerous Formula One track. If you haven't seen it, I do recommend Rush. Ron Howard makes a good film. Daniel Brühl is uncanny as Lauda, and Hemsworth is pretty good as James Hunt. And Olivia Wilde is smoking hot as Susie Miller. But even as a Formula One fan who saw Rush in theaters, I never sought it out again until this review. Though it's well done, there isn't a scene I really want to see again, there's not any dialogue I long to hear again, and there's no interaction between the actors that I really want to see again. To me, that is something really missing, because not only do those types of things keep me re-watching some of my favorite movies, but every year during the F1 season, I find all the personalities on the grid, even the driest, very entertaining. Well, of course, some more than others. I also appreciate well-done moments of exposition in a film where music and or visuals can make even a car sitting in a garage very stirring. Rush never does anything special with all these great cars and tracks. It lacks the touch of filmmakers who really have an eye for F1. The only visual flair is all the camera filters that every film today is using. The iconic anatomy of these legendary racetracks is mostly buried in a haze of quick close-ups of race cars and pistons and concept shots. I was kind of underwhelmed with the film score, but it might be kind of buried in the mix, except for the odd low-frequency effect that just blasts out of nowhere. It's not a terrible score, but it comes off as pretty standard fare in the film. When I read that this score is by Hans Zimmer, I laughed. It sounded like Hans Zimmer. It sounded like the Hans Zimmer Music Factory, but for this movie, I still expect something more from it. Listening to the music on its own, I did appreciate certain cues a lot more. I do recommend this film, especially to F1 fans, but if I have to rate this film, then it's open to more scrutiny like I've already detailed, and it's a tough one for me to put a number on. How do I rate a film that is good and I recommend? But some things are really lacking for me, and I really don't see wanting to rewatch this much. There are bad movies that I find endlessly entertaining to revisit after all. In Formula One, you can have a great driver or a great car, but if you don't have everything at its peak, the car, the driver, the strategy, the pit crew, you can't win the race. They did a good job with Rush. They absolutely made it to the podium. But for me, unfortunately, not to the very top. I'm going to give Rush 4 beautiful grid grills out of 5. And unfortunately, thanks to the jackasses at Formula One Management, That's 4 grid grills more than we're going to get in F1 anymore.
Oh, it's dirty politics and dirty tricks. That's what's going wrong.